Hey, Tina. Bennett is not talking to you. Well, what do you do? Hey, some of you side chicks, you guys are very disrespectful. You know that, right? This man is risking his entire soul to go to hell by committing adultery with you side chicks, and then you got a nerve to be cheating on him, and then you got a nerve to bring another man in your house where he comes to come and commit adultery with you. Why would you do that? I always encourage you side chicks to not cheat on my husband. What he's doing, he's sacrificing his soul. He's sacrificing his soul to eternal damnation. It's I mean, he's sacrificing the time he's supposed to give me and the children. He's sacrificing some money. He's cutting his lifespan shorter by distributing this, by constantly releasing all the fluid out of his body for just putting extra work and strain on his body. And then instead of y'all being loyal to this man, helping me to cook, do all the cooking, helping me to come here clean, helping me to carry his children there and do some things for your stepchildren, helping his family back home, helping y'all supposed. But you're supposed to be focused on everything that man need, everything his children need, and everything that I need as his wife for all the pain and suffering. But no, the man stressing himself to satisfy y'all and abandoning some of his responsibility with his family, and then y'all, so you being very ungrateful by sneaking another man in there to cheat on him. And you expect him to talk to you. You already the side chick. You already the side dish. So he don't need to go the extra mile to stress over you. He can stress over me, but he would never stress over you. Talk to him. I can talk to him for free though. Oh, no. I can't talk to him for free. It's just too much stimulus check rolling in lately. I can't talk to him for free. You a nurse too? I can't talk to him for free. You know some things that I need right now? All my weave caps, I've been having them for almost 2 years now, girl. They're beat up. I need some real Remy hair, Brazilian hair. I got quite a few choices. I need some weave caps, some braided ones, some short ones, some long ones. I need some weave caps, you know. And there are also, I really need to up, you know, like I really need to like, you know, upgrade my underwear and stuff like that, you know, because I've been, you know, y'all been putting me through a lot of stress. I've forgotten by myself a little bit. You know, I need some bras and some underwears and stuff like that. You could take me shopping. Let me pick what I want, what I like and stuff like that. And you gotta give me cash too. Oh, well, I'm talking about 5 grand. Yeah, I mean, you want me to talk to him, right? As far as I know, he already replaced you. He's only allowed 3 side chicks at a time. He's only allowed 3 side chicks at a time. If you don't do what I'm asking you to do, girlfriend, you just gonna have to get in the waiting line. You just gonna have to wait in the waiting line. But if you give me the 5 grand, take me shopping for things I need a full body massage, because you're telling me to beg my husband to consider, you know, to consider keeping you as a side chick. You know, I mean, like, you're so selfish right now. You're not even thinking about how this is so much trauma for me, emotionally, mentally, physically, spiritually. Oh, you're not even thinking about that. But we don't need to think about that. I know you got that money. You got you got the steamy rolling in. You're a nurse and everything, you know. So all you got to do, I need a full body massage from the tip of my follicles all the way down to the tip of my toenail. I need a full body massage the whole week, the $5,000 and the shopping spree. Yeah, I need to pick me up some new bras and some new underwear and stuff like that. And the website I've been looking at to pick some of the wigs, I'm just going to go and send you all the links. And you're just going to buy it and send it straight to the address here. I know you got savings. You into stock markets. You got IRAs, accounts. You got savings. I know all this because you're messing with my husband. I know the ones that he's supposed to keep. Honestly, he needs to keep you, but you can't be doing stuff like that. You can't be doing stuff like that. You can't be stepping out on a married man. You can't be doing that. That's bad for his reputation. Listen. That's all you gotta do. If you do that, I will talk him out of replacing you. Because as far as I'm concerned, he's replacing you right now. And once he replaces you, girlfriend, you're gonna go at the bottom of the list. You're gonna be on the waiting list. And until you do it, until you're ready to do it, don't be calling my phone. Don't be calling me if you're not ready to do it. I'm just saying, I don't want no unnecessary headache from you. I didn't encourage you to go and cheat on my husband. You know, I didn't encourage you to do what you did. That was very wrong. That was very wrong. You and him, y'all already going to hell, and you adding more insult to the injury that the both of y'all inflicting on yourself. Y'all self-destructing, and then you adding more to it. It's not making any sense, Tina. It's not making any sense. You spoil a perfectly good adulterous relationship. You mess it up. Try to be faithful, loyal. Why? If you're doing that to him, how you expect him to trust you to come over to your house? He's a married man. You know, he can't be risking his life, you bringing other dudes there. They could do other things to him. No, I definitely don't support that because I don't want that happening to my husband. I'm very disappointed in you. But if you're serious, holler at me when you got whatever I requested, okay? All right. Girl, don't cry. Don't cry. Get you a few toys. Don't cry. Call me when you're ready, though. All right, bye.